Hey guys, today I am here to talk to you about 5 pieces of business advice to internalize before you get started. It can be terrifying to finally take that leap of faith in yourself, in your business, and finally put your passions to work, because that's a really scary thing when you don't depend on anyone else but yourself, because if you fail, it's only your fault. And you know, who wants to feel like a failure? Just on that note, you're never a failure, but I know that is like that's my worst fear when I started, was what if I don't make it? Anyway, let's dive in, shall we? So I recently wrote a blog post on this. You can go and check it out on the website, francescamccohen.com. I am giving a lot more business advice just because, you know, when I first started my entrepreneurial journey, I didn't even realize I was an entrepreneur. I didn't really ever think I could be an entrepreneur. I never really wanted to be an entrepreneur. I thought it was a lot of work. I'd much rather be someone's like number two and let them like worry about everything, and I just do whatever it is that they need me to do. But I fell into it and I love it, and I could never go back. I'm not sure if I could be someone's number two now. Anyway, so this is just based on my experiences for the past 8 years of going through numerous different types of businesses. But the number one thing to internalize before you're even gonna start your business is to shut out the noise. So many people have opinions, but remember, people's opinions don't pay your bills. I also believe that everybody has had a million-dollar idea. Sarah Blakely? With Spanx even says this. And she's even given the advice to keep your idea to yourself. It takes one person to doubt your idea. And it is so hard to overcome that, especially if they're like someone you really, really love and trust. So shut out the noise, keep your idea very, very close to your heart, and just make the decisions to make it happen. Number two, only listen to your gut. So we're taught hustle. To make money, it has to feel hard. You have to work hard. You have to make sacrifices. Life is hard. But that's not really true. And I have to say, it's only up until recently that I've started realizing this. Used to, I'd be like, the longer hours I would work, or the more days I would work, or the more difficult client I would work with, that would make it more rewarding. That then I would be more deserving of money that I would make from it. And instead of listening to my gut of, I don't want to work for this client, I really don't want to work weekends, I really don't want to do this job anymore, I would just push myself. And it made me resentful. So listen to your gut. Your gut never lies. Your gut's never like, just kidding, I didn't mean that. No, listen to your gut. Okay, number three, profit first. Woo, profit first method sets me on fire. And if you haven't started a business yet, you probably don't really know what this means, but you probably could also do this in your own personal life. So profit first method means that we're reversing the psychology of what we're taught in school, which is revenues minus expenses equal profit. Mm-mm, nope, you need to take your profit first. We are not in the business because it's like a hobby, okay? So we are in the business of growing sustainable, profitable businesses. So it's profit equals revenue minus expenses. And what happens is that you quickly realize if you're just, your expenses are out of control. You do not have enough money coming in to cover those expenses. So guess what? Maybe you don't hire that additional team member. Maybe you don't buy those extra uniforms. Maybe you don't do that photo shoot, whatever it is. Profit first method. And I talk all about this in the blog. If you want to go check it out, francescamccohen.com. I'm probably going to do a whole nother IGTV on profit first. So let's get through this. I want to do these 5 steps in 5 minutes. Okay. 4, you get what you pay for. So remember, if you're going to be making investments in your business, budget for them, but budget realistically. If you want someone who's really going to be your right hand, and who's gonna help you build out your business, they're gonna cost more than somebody who's just starting out. So be very realistic and remember what you invest your money in is the return you're gonna get. Okay, and number 5, don't be afraid to pivot. Don't worry about what you might feel like in 5 years. Worry about how you feel right now. So right now you wanna do X, don't worry about if you don't wanna do X in a year. You'll worry about that in a year. Pivoting is called evolution, and we evolve as humans. So Those are my five pieces of business advice to internalize before you get started in 5 minutes.